Hello students, today we are going to start with a new topic, that is wound. Now what is a wound? Wound is a break in the integrity of skin or tissue, often which may be associated with disruption of structure and function. So actually wound is an injury to the living tissue which is caused by either a cut or a blow or any other impact. In this condition, the skin is cut or broken. If you see classification of wound, they are basically classified into two categories, that is tidy wounds and untidy wounds. And this classification was done by Rank and Wakefield, and it is most useful from practical point of view. In this picture, you can see that this is a tidy wound. Whereas if you compare this wound with the picture below, you can see that this wound is untidy wound. There is lot of devitalized tissue, lot of dirty slough, dirty material. So this is an untidy wound. Now what is a tidy wound? Surgical incisions and wounds which are caused by sharp objects like knife or a glass. These are classified into tidy wounds. The tendons, nerves and arteries are commonly injured in this type of injury. Fracture is uncommon and healing occurs by primary intention. And this healing can be assisted by primary suturing. So the time which will be required for the wound to heal will automatically become less. Untidy wounds, these are the wounds that result from crushing, tearing, avulsion, vascular injuries and burns. This type of wounds, they contain devitalized tissue. The skin wound are multiple and irregular. Fracture of the underlying bone may occur at times. And there is delay in wound healing because these are untidy wounds which are containing infection. Wounds are usually not closed by primary suturing, but before opting for primary suturing, it is better that you excise the devitalized tissue. And if you see that now this wound has been converted into a tidy wound, then you can go for wound closing. Then there are different types of wounds. Bruises and contusion, hematoma, punctured wounds and bites, lacerations, abrasions and friction burns, traction and avulsion injury, crush injury, war wounds and gunshot injuries, injuries to bones and joints, injuries to nerves and injuries to arteries and veins. We'll see one by one these types of wounds. So coming on to the first type, that is bruises and contusions. These are also known as ecchymosis. It is caused by a close blunt injury. Here you can see that there is a discoloration here. This is because of bleeding under the skin. Typically, this discoloration, which is black or blue in color, may persist for days or months also. Usually no specific treatment is required. It will heal by itself, but it will take time. At times, these types of blunt injury may cause fat necrosis. And the best example is blunt injury to the breast, which causes fat necrosis, and patient presents with a lump in breast. Abrasion and friction wounds. These are superficial and this is due to shearing of the skin where the surface is rubbed off. Usually when you fall from a moving vehicle or your vehicle gets slipped off, at that time you get this type of injury, and this type of injury usually heals by epithelialization in 7 to 10 days. Now hematoma. Hematoma is nothing but collection of blood outside of the blood vessel, and it causes a localized tumor-like appearance. If this hematoma is big enough, that time you have to go for a surgery. You have to evacuate this hematoma. And if this is of a smaller size, then that can be done by a large bore needles. You can aspirate the collection under the skin. And many times if the hematoma is small, it usually automatically gets reabsorbed without scarring. Actually, hematoma and ecchymosis is not much different. In hematoma, there is lot of collection. That's why it is giving a tumor-like appearance. And that's why it is called as hematoma. So if the injury is big, that leads to hematoma. Laceration of wound. Wound which is produced by tearing of soft tissue. Here you can see that there is lot of tearing of the soft tissue. This wound is irregular and jagged. And usually the lacerated wound is contaminated with bacteria and debris from the object which has caught that or which has caused that cut. So this is a lacerated injury. Then punctured wounds and bites. These are usually caused by sharp pointy objects such as a nail or an animal bite, because the teeth of animal are quite sharp, so they can cause punctured wounds. They does not bleed excessively on the surface, but within or beneath there is lot of bleeding, and at times there is infection also, because the organism which is present in the mouth of that animal can lead to infection of the wound. And in that case, they give rise to an abscess which is deep within the tissue. This is a picture where you can compare a laceration from a punctured wound. In case of laceration, there is lot of destruction of the tissue. Whereas in case of punctured wounds, the injury is quite deep beneath. Then war wounds and gunshot injuries are associated with a different variety or severity of tissue damage, which depends on the injury, whether it is a low velocity or a high velocity. Usually in case of low velocity, that is gunshot injuries, results in a wound of entry and a wound of exit, and there is tissue contamination from the dirt which is present on the clothing. Whereas in case of high velocity, usually which are caused by rifles, there is explosive pressure and decompression effect, and there is widespread tissue damage, which injury to the major vessels. Traction and avulsion injuries. Avulsions are open injuries where there has been a severe degree of tissue damage. Here you can see that lot of tissue has been damaged, and these types of injuries are usually caused when the hands or limbs are trapped in moving machineries like the rollers. So these types of injuries are usually encountered in factories, producing degloving injury. Then crush injury. This is again a type of blunt injury. This leads to compartment syndrome, muscle ischemia and gangrene. This injury occurs when the part or the body is squeezed between two heavy objects. So usually that leads to a crush injury. In this picture, you can see the look of the crush injury. So we have seen different types of wounds, injury to the bones and joints that may lead to fracture, which may be open or a closed fracture. Injury to nerves can be either clean cut or crush injuries, and injuries to arteries and veins, where a wound is associated with much bleeding, there is possibility that a large vessel has been divided. So we have completed with the topic wound